Sweet dreams, everyone. Prayers for Ruby. Angels for Ruby. I was awake. Keeps shutting off. I hate that. Hello and welcome. If you are here for the first time, it's not a coincidence, I'm sure. My name is Bonnie, I'm the founder of Life Changing Grace, and it is an extreme pleasure to have you joining me in supporting the channel with your likes and subscriptions and shares, period. I'm noticing that we got caption here, which is something new that I started, and I'm reading it at the same time. But anyway, I just wanted to come in here and let you know that an update on Ruby. She's doing great. It's a up and down hill. You know, it's like a roller coaster. She's fine one moment and then she declines the next. And her brain is still functioning and waking her up when her breathing gets really shallow and slow. I'm monitoring her, I'm holding her. She's like my baby, cuddling her like a baby. Actually treating her just like a baby that might be sick, you know. And it seems like that really, like right now, she's right next to me sleeping and whining a little bit more than normal. She's getting an odor from her bowel, which is not a good sign. So your prayers and your concerns are greatly appreciated. Once again, I want to spare her the death, going through death experience, and having a nice experience. This would be the first time for me to go through anything like that, and it's kind of a touchy subject when I'm talking to people. They're like, oh, their accommodations are, I mean, it's like renting a hotel or something, you know? And it's just like the way they talk, it just really kind of gets me anxiety, because like I said, it's almost like they're selling a vacation or something like that, you know? And all I want to do is just hold her. Hold her as she goes to sleep. And that's the thing, is that if we don't get collect the money on time, of course, it's greatly appreciated. The prayers for an easy pass away and for the Lord to take her quickly quickly in her sleep. I've been prophesying that over her and praying about that when the time comes.
Ruby, what are you doing?
Heaven's waiting patiently. I've heard that somewhere, and it's just a sticking in this time of a little bit of grief. This transition into something that's unknown for me is a journey, and I welcome you to it too. And I greatly recommend, you know, I encourage you to, you know, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, but to leave a comment below. Have you gone through this before? How was it for you? What were your thoughts? You know, I mean, you know, your support, you guys have been supporting me ever since St. Augustine, but now that I'm home, things have slowed down a little bit. But I greatly appreciate your comments and your concerns, and I more than gladly love to let you know a little bit about Ruby. She has her own channel, Stayin' Alive Alliance, and I have another channel as an addition to, which is Benita, which is my name in Spanish. Benita, life-changing, Benita, Stayin' Alive Alliance, and that is to the animals. It's dedicated through her to the animals that are unfortunate, have been unloved, and mistreated, neglected. You know, animal rescue is what it's all about, and training our animals and loving our animals, understanding our animals. A lot of you call me like the animal whisperer, you know, so, which, you know, that just tickles me when I hear you guys say that. So, I kind of like adopted that, and in a way, yeah, you know, which I've helped many also understand how to communicate with their animals, because they're just like the Holy Spirit. They don't have no voice. So, and maybe when we're aggravated and we're not really paying attention to our animals, they're trying to communicate to us, like Ruby. She doesn't see, she can't see anything, and she was letting me know that something was wrong with me, you know, and having seizures in my sleep. I didn't know.
You're gonna fall.
So, that, and then my dog, my cur dog, he kept getting underneath my feet all the time, and I was pacing. I'm trying to fill out court papers. I'm basically like my own attorney, you know, except for I don't have an agent number, which kind of sucks. But anyway, I really wish I could submit these papers. If I was an attorney or an investigator, I could. So I'm just minus, you know, an agent's number, you know, like a cop is a number, or like a military, you get a number, or you're in jail, you have a number. So, so it's just like my dog is trying to slow me down, going, you know, pacing. I've been under a lot of stress the past 3 years. Up until this year, I've been off my enalapril, my blood pressure. I was completely immune to stressful situations, and still slightly am, but I'm back on my medication again. Just temporarily. I never take any medicine that I'm completely on at all times. Which stress also affects your sugar levels, and they've been all out of whack these past 3 weeks. And no matter what it has nothing to do with what I'm eating, because I'm not eating anything that would do that. So it's basically going up and down, up and down. So our dogs communicate with us, with keeping us balanced, keeping us healthy, keeping us alive, you know what I mean? So I dedicate my life to that too, you know, the less fortunate, the ones that can't defend that for themselves. I defend for them. I'm sure, I mean, hit that bell. I mean, I know that there's a lot of you out there do the same thing. So, and what I was just getting to, if you want to know a little bit about Ruby, I had a Chihuahua before her. She got stolen after surgery, and we were looking for her. And I was walking the streets at night right after surgery just looking for my dog. I was in an area where they did steal Chihuahuas. And, we ran across her right around my birthday. I had to get out of town. I went and visited my other children. And my son-in-law went and picked Ruby up. Yeah, she did. She acted, looked at everything like my dog, the baby girl. But she was just older. And when I got her, she could not receive love. So what love I was starting to give her, and then I was jumping in and out of the hospital, just the love that I was giving her, and she'd freak out when I did go to the hospital, tear up my whole room. So she totally changed within a 6-month period. She was not the same dog anymore. But I knew the certain traits and stuff that she was doing. She wasn't obviously not allowed on the bed. And if she was on the bed, she was like in the corner down at the foot of the bed. You know, so we filled each other's gaps at the right time at the right moment. And she had a stroke. I was at the beach with her, and I should have known better. So she lost her first eye, and then she lost her second eye to she lost her second eye to glaucoma. So she did last year. She set the second eye, so she's been completely blind. The other eye kind of struck up. So, our animals, there's so much we can learn from our animals. from animals, period. All kinds of animals. They don't have their head in it, so they go blind, or they lose a leg, or there's some kind of deformity on them. They're not in it emotionally as we would. So, and dogs just, they take healing, they expect.
Okay, Rube, just wait 1 minute, baby things. Girls.
But when I got Ruby, she if I tried to hug her like I do now, it was like she pushed away. She just didn't. So she didn't exactly take love very much. You know, there's a lot of us out there like that. We're afraid to love. We're afraid to, you know, we're pushing people away. So she was very neglected and mistreated, obviously. I really didn't notice this until now, but it looks like a couple of her teeth have been broken off.
Generally, that means she's got to go.
That's the thing, too, is that when she does fall off things like the soap or whatever, she's very graceful. She rolls. You know, it's like when you're on fire, you duck and roll. You know. So, I mean, it's almost like someone threw her.
Oh, come on, Rube. You're going to do this right now? She goes. Wherever I lead her. And I'll bring her line like this way. And I'll bring her back around this way. This way.